good. Feel good. Got a win. It's a good win. It was necessary. I won't say just because it was 51-3. It was great to see our guys go out and execute. You know, so we talked about a lot of this going out and executing and play the kind of ball game that we know we can play. And it was good to see that.
Offense seemed to struggle in the first couple of series, but what were the adjustments that you made to get them back on the board
again? We just needed to settle down. You know, it wasn't anything they were doing. It was all what we were doing. You know, either missing a block or missing a guy that was open or whatever it was, a penalty or something. It was more of us. You know, it was just us settling down and going out and executing like we say we're going to do. That was it. We didn't have much in offensively because we wanted to execute. So a lot of it was just us calming down and had to relax a little bit and then go out and execute the play like we was capable of. But it was good to see our guys. I told our guys before the game that family, you was going to come in and fight. And just because they fight and things don't go the way that we wanted them to go early, don't mean we get frustrated. Don't mean we put our head down. We just got to keep fighting, keep working. And for me personally, that was great to see out of our guys. They took all the things we talked about during this week, they literally took it to the game, and that was good to see that our guys didn't put their head down because things wasn't going well early. And you know, you're playing them, and they're well. You should do this, you should do that. But it's the first college football game, and anything can happen. It was just great to see our guys just keep playing and keep fighting. You know, that's something we hadn't done a lot.
What do you think about how Quentin responded after that pick in the first quarter?
I thought he responded well. You know, it was a pick that he shouldn't have thrown. Or maybe he just run like he's capable of doing. Just run. He don't throw that. But again, that was kind of like I was saying earlier, how we just wasn't sharp. We had to relax a little bit. You know, he was trying to do too much. You know, rather than just read your keys. If he just read his keys, he would have knew not to throw that ball. So, but it was good. Again, Quentin, just like our entire football team. He bounced back. He didn't get frustrated and get down on himself. He just came back. It was good to see his teammates over, pat him on his back and build him up. Say, hey, don't worry about it. We come back when we play. It was good to see that on the sideline. It was like that all night. That was great. I didn't have to say much. You know, I was sitting back watching. Like, this is awesome.
You kept Marlin in the game. In fact, he got the ball the next two plays after the high-stepping penalty. A lot of coaches, I mean, let's be honest, would probably have the kid on the sideline chewing him out, and you didn't do that. Is that by design? What was your thought process there?
I think every person, everybody's different. Marlon's not a guy that normally gets a personal foul. Marlon's one of the guys that normally just do everything right, you know, and he got his first personal foul, and I let him know I was disappointed in it, but he had to come back and make it up, you know, and he did.
How has he changed in a year? Last year was the 275 and 4 TDs.
Just a year older. He's a year older and stronger. You know, other than that, he hadn't changed much. He still can run. And he can catch football. He can make guys miss. I mean, he's picked up some weight from last year. He picked up some weight. But other than all that, I mean, he's still marvelous.
What impressed you about your defense tonight?
They were just flying around. You know, they're flying around and you've seen multiple guys around the ball, you know, multiple guys around the ball, and they were having fun. You just watch those guys having fun with each other when they were flying around, but more important is how they would get to the ball. Again, we stressed that a lot, and Coach Allen is all over those guys about getting to the ball, and that was good to see. You know, we wanted to get the ball out a little more than what we did, but it was great for them to fly around. That's what we expect. That's kind of what we want out of that defense.
Kano.
All right. Okay, we got to say that right now. He had a great game. We got to get his name right.
Is that going to earn him any more playing time?
Oh, he's going to play. He played a lot tonight. And did a great job, too. What do you have? 4 catches, 126 shots. Do you think he's going to play more? No, but that was we knew what we had in Kano. And what you all saw tonight, we saw that all last year. He did that to our defense and scout team last year, and we knew we had a player there. And been talking to Kano all week. It's your time. You've been waiting on this and all day today. Every time I saw him in the hallway, I'm, what are you going to do? Barbecue a meal? Just put me in, coach. And sure enough, he went out and made those plays. Not only did he catch the ball, he did a great job lining up for the catch. You know, he's a big kid and very, very talented. And, he's a young kid, too. You know, I'm looking at all our guys making plays. They're all young kid, freshman, sophomore. That's great. It's exciting.
Getting to see the new defensive scheme against a different team than your own, finally. What did you see that was better than last year's, even the better fit?
Defensively?
Yeah.
I wouldn't say, I mean, it's hard to just say it right now. I haven't watched the film, but, again, I love the way the guys ran through the ball. I mean, they were around the ball. They didn't give up any big plays. But they were constantly around the ball. They wasn't really out of position. You know, I mean, when the guy called the ball, somebody was there. Now, we can get better on some tackle. We missed some tackles there, but for the most part, we were where we were supposed to be, and we got the job done.
What can you say about
Gotta shut up.
What can you say about Hector's play at
two? Oh, he was awesome. That was great, you know. Special hometown guy, you know, Tampa guy, go out there. It was great for Bruce. Bruce been waiting this time to get out there and play, and for him to play that the way he did, I mean, that was big. I think that's going to help his confidence so much. And not only him, the guys around him, too, just helped him out. It was great to see how his teammate was so excited for him to make those plays. You know, he's just one of those kids that worked his tail off every single day. Don't complain about anything. He just go out and work, and it's paying off for him.
Why the change to Steven?
Because we said we're going to do it. We said we're going to put him in second series, second half, and let him go. So we did. He did a great job.
Coach, the student section was packed tonight. Is this a preview of what they can expect to see?
That was big time, big time, big time. The best student section in the country. That was big time, and I tell you what, that's a big reason why our guys played the way they did. To have the student section behind the crowd just loud into the game, and that was big for our guys, you know. And it was great to see you come out. You get to run down there, and all of them so enthusiastic and just. Big time, you know, and we intend on playing that way, you know, and keep it that way, you know. That's how Ray J should be. Now we're gonna keep doing what we have to do and try to build this thing up and have it be like that in a tire bowl, you know. But we're gonna crawl before we walk and climb our way up. I say climbing is easier than hanging on. So keep climbing.
Michigan State has Rich on the Kwan. Does USF have flies now? Is that like a thing? Is that you saw the video?
I don't know if USF has flies. Plies a good friend, and he told me he was coming to the game, and he wanted to make sure that I knew he was there and came by. Our players always ask, when Plies coming back? When Plies coming back? And sure enough, he came in the locker room, and it went crazy. Like, geez. But that was good for him to come over and support the Bulls. You know, he said he's with the Bulls all the way, so it's good.
Coach?
Y'all have to have some more. That was a good win for the Bulls. Y'all gotta have something else for me now. Come on now. It's been a long time coming. Y'all gotta have something for me.
How happy are you?
Hi.
I knew you'd smile.
I'm so happy with our players. You know, I mentioned earlier, ever since December, these kids have been working their tail off. They've been working. We have a band, we talk about being all in. Our guys have been all in. I'm so happy with those guys, the way they competed, and everything I asked them to do, they've been doing it. You know, they haven't been complaining about it. Just do it. We got you, coach. And I'm very happy with our staff. I mean, I thought our coaching staff did a great job of preparing our guys and the way they helped get our players to come together. You know, but I think our players see that with our staff. They see how close our staff is, and it just filtered throughout those guys. I'm happy with all of them. They all did a great job. But there's still a lot of work, you know. There's still a lot of work to be done. There's a lot of things that can be corrected in that football game. One is penalties. You know, we're going to be a winning football team. We got to play like a winning football team. We got to be disciplined like a winning football team. And from that standpoint, we wasn't. But that's something we can correct. And they always say you make your most improvement from game one to game two. And got a hell of a game two coming up. So we'll see how much this football team improves.